Today we are talking about Karla Kattai and Karla Kattai benefits. People are interesting and want to know about some details about Karla Kattai and the fitness, the traditional fitness. If anyone have doubt about it, you can ask me the questions.
Yes, Master. Thank you, Master. It is a golden opportunity to be with you this moment. So my question is, in what movements and signs Karla Kattai is different from all the other fitness exercises?
Okay, the difference between the Karla Kattai traditional fitness is called a traditional fitness. We called as a Marabu Kalai in Tamil. Marabu Kalai means a genetic training from our tradition, our tradition. And so it's one of the ancient art of Tamil Nadu. It's more than 6,000 years old, because we are following the culture through all the way. So what is the difference between the new, the modern fitness and traditional fitness? The different, lot of difference in physical difference and energy level difference and posture difference, a lot of difference from the breathing difference, structural difference, you know, the endurance difference, the strength and difference. So lot of difference you can see already, modern fitness and traditional fitness. So I can explain you a little bit. Example, I can explain to you. Like in yoga, you use a body to be used as a flexibility. Flexibility is the strength of yoga. Flexibility and using with the body is a flexibility, and using a breathing is breathing is your life source from yoga. In Karla Kattai, three different varieties of practice in Karla Kattai. One is strengthening, second is a flexibility, third is energy level. So you have to strengthening your body, strengthening your energy, so you correction your positions. So you all merge together into be one training, it's called Karla Kattai.
Thank you, Master. So in today's modern exercise science, people talk about cardio endurance, people talk about their lung energy, people talk about their posture. In Karla Kattai, it's around 6,000 years old, even more than that. How it was designed in terms of covering all this alignment part, also a person's strength level, and you were talking about the energy level. So give us a clarity on how it enhances a person's posture in terms of energy level and also strength level, Master.
So in Karla Kattai, we are divided into in terms of practicing our physical training. In Karla Kattai, we have different size of Karla Kattai. We use it for postures and muscle training and joint mobility or joints, and then the movements all you studied in a different size of Karla Kattai. So in first Karla Kattai is called Kai Karalai. Kai Karalai, it's helping to move your body, like a movement the body. It's called a swing bell. In English it's called a swing bell. Take a Karla Kattai and swing the Karla Kattai. When you swing the Karla Kattai, you get the proper movement, proper mobility from your shoulders and elbows and wrist and your finger joints, everything. So it helps to improve your strengthening your arms from Kai Karalai. Kai Karalai is the first Karalai you start with. That is the most important Karalai. We start with Kai Karalai. The Kai Karalai must be dimensions of the size of Karla Kattai, the width of Karla Kattai, and the size of your arms, and everything. There's the mathematical structure of the Karla Kattai from Kai Karalai. The Kai Karalai is helping for basic training of Karla Kattai. The second Karla Kattai is called Bhuja Karalai. It's helping to strengthening your muscles. So strengthening your tissues, strengthening your muscles and the connecting tissues and endurance. It helps your breathings. It's called Bhuja Karalai. So Bhuja Karalai is the tree is a like not density tree. The only specific tree you can use for Bhujakaralai. After finishing Bhujakaralai, you go for Kustikaralai. Kustikaralai is all, sorry, after using, third one is using Topakaralai. It's called a tummy karalai. It's like a tummy shape. Because why it's called tummy karalai? It's look like a tummy shape. It is practiced by farmers. And that karalakattai use only farmers used this karalakattai. Because the farmers work harder, but they have still put the tummy. Because they don't have the center body, they doesn't work out. So they use to kill that stomach, the obesity. So they use called a tummy karalai, they use. So that karalakattai is a shape is like a tummy. That's why it's called a tummy karalai. Then kusti karalai. Kusti karalai is the wrestlers will practice kusti karalai. Then the pudivarisai, the like the grappling techniques people use, malliyuttam, like belt wrestling kind of people use. Pudikaralai. Pudikaralai is quite high and quite tall karalai and very big karalai. It's more than 10 to 15 kilo weight. It's giving you big, strong strength, the strengthening your body. And then you have the strong gravity as well. It gives you big gravity in your body. So that's why you use the Pudikaralai. So this kind of karalakattai is all around you. You do this karalakattai. It's a help to strengthen your body and then make your conditioning your body. It's giving you the proper conditioning for physical fitness. Like you are a wrestler, you are a fighter, you are archer, you are swordsman, you are horse rider. So the old type of civilizations used in the different type of karalakattai, in five karalakattai. So also it helps to boost your energy level in the organs. That's why the karalakattai people used, still they use the karalakattai, they feel fit. Quickly they feel fit.
Great, Master. So this shows that the strength level is like from a basic person, normal fitness, to warrior fitness, to samurai level or archer, and it goes on and on. It's like a different level of strength and endurance what you have told. So it is very interesting to hear from you. Thank you, Master.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Master. You have explained about the type of the different karalakattais. So I have a question on this. So can different type of karalakattai, the trees, can give the different kind of benefits to us? We have seen the different kind of wood over here, which is made up of. So can this give a different kind of results and benefits of this?
In our culture, there's a tree is one of the, like, you know, the trees also have the benefit of medicine. And they're giving you health benefits.
Uh-huh.
Okay, like example, you know, the iron box. Iron box is called is karangali.
Okay.
In Tamil, karangali. So even the axe cannot cut the karangali. Axe also will break with the karangali. In Tamil, they have a proverb called Kodaliki Anjada Karangali. So even the axe also broken by the wood. So why it was axe is broken is the wood is look like stronger than iron. So that's why it's karangali. So like example, like karangali is used to made with the karalakattai. It's only specific karalakattai. It's a Bhujakaralai. When you use a karangali as a karangali karalakattai, you give a lot of iron ores in the karalakattai. So you get iron, you get copper, sulfur, potassium, a lot of minerals in the tree.
Okay.
So that's why they use the karangali in the medicine. Karangali also used as a heart medicine.
Okay.
A lot of people using in our Siddha science also, they're using as a medicine for heart disease. Also for meek also they use. Okay. So that karalakattai we use for Bhujakaralai. And then some other tree called nookamaram.
Mm-hmm.
In Tamil called nookamaram, is called in English is a rosewood.
Mm-hmm.
Rosewood is used to make kustikaralai.
Mm-hmm.
So rosewood, if you practice rosewood, it's good for vata disease. Any disease, waterborne disease, any windborne disease, wind spreading disease, it helps for wind disease.
Mm-hmm.
So there are benefit like tamarind tree.
Mm-hmm.
Tamarind tree, the core of the tamarind tree also is we used tamarind tree, and then we use red wood. We use for cedar tree.
Okay.
Cedar tree, and then there are a lot of trees we use for medicinal purpose. So all the trees we using in karalakattai. it's all have the health benefit. Without health benefit, we don't use. That's why we can't paint it or varnish the karlakattai.
Oh, okay. That's why it is in raw form.
Yeah, raw form. After you made the karlakattai, you applied castor oil and neem oil mixed together and apply on karlakattai. Then you can't pass the bacteria to the karlakattai. Even your uric acid comes out of the sweat. It can't go into the karlakattai because the oil dense of oil will push out of all the toxin.
Okay.
So after you can clean the karlakattai.
Master, how do you relate this with your spiritual aspect? What is the benefit of the spiritual benefit of this doing the karlakattai?
The spiritual is your health being only. What is your spirituality? Spirituality is and spirituality and health is not two different things. Spirituality and health is the same thing. If you feel healthy, you are in a spiritual. If you feel unhealthy, you are non-spiritual. That's why in our culture. That's why we called un udambur alayam, means body it became a temple and the soul became a god. That's why in Tamil culture we follow up. So you have to follow your healthy life. Then you have to practice the karlakattai to take care of your health. Then automatically you will be in spirituality. So the gods will live in the clean place. How your body is clean, you feel fit and healthy, your body is clean, the god automatically come and live in your heart. So that is your spirituality. How you don't, you can't search the spirituality outside of your life.
So basically the spiritual means being healthy.
Being healthy.
Okay, thank you. Master. So, what is your stand on this different, the other traditional arts on with this?
There are different traditional and different things. I can talk about somebody's traditions is better than ours because we are already following our ancestors' art. The ancestors are practicing for a thousand and thousand and thousands of years of practicing, but they can't put it on in a grammatic way of fitness. Fitness is basically a training one. It's not a speaking one. You can't talk it to you. You can't write it in the notes. Anything. You're all talking about how do you practice and how do you get a benefit. So it's all considered to be how long you practice. Your practice for 10,000 hours any art, you will become a master. That's
expertise.
In 10,000 hours you practice, you become a master in this.
Yes.
That's a Western belief. Yeah. But what is Indian belief? You have to 12 hours every day. You have to practice.
Oh.
12 hours of practice
in a day.
And then you have to practice until your 12 years. That became you became a saint in this art.
Philosophy. Oh, okay.
You don't mean say 12 hours. You don't means you're just practicing the health because of practicing. You are eating healthy food, also called as a practicing. You also do pranayamam, kshatriya pranayam is also called as a practice. So you have to do all the life living in 12 years to completely dedicate yourself to the art. Then you become a saint in this art, not the master in the art. That's why we called every art you have to learn 12 years completion.
Wow. Well, master, thank you. And we have noticed the two things while practicing. One is that you said mai padam, another thing is rotating the karla, that karlakattai practices. So practicing maipadam, is it essential? Is it just a warm-up or does it have a different kind of health benefit to us, or why should we practice that before?
There's two things before you're practicing a karlakattai. One is a maipadam in called is a understanding your body. Maipadam, that is called understanding your body. Then one more is udal kattu padam, fit your body, make your body fit.
Okay.
Okay. Fitness, fit, make you, how to make your body fit. Okay. Yeah. That's called udal kattu padam.
Oh.
Then only you jump on karlakattai.
Okay.
Karlakattai is conditioning your life. Conditioning, like you prepare your body into be a warrior, or a farmer, or a dancer, or a swimmer, or anything. You can take only depends on the 64 rotations. You take a couple of rotations, you practice, you are conditioning your body.
Oh,
so that is the preparations. After preparation, condition finish, conditioning finish, after you go for a warrior or whatever your culture you follow up. Okay. So based on the culture, there are the movement, the rotations you follow up. So this is and all is a basic of warriors in traditional Pallava warriors practicing karlakattai.
So basically, Maipadam and then fitness kind of thing, and then Karla. And among this, or for 64 round, different kind of things, we can choose any one of things according to our need.
Our needs.
For example, dancer can choose
needs something. And,
Oh, super muscle. This is very nice to have. And can this be done by any age group, or do you have any age limits? Only this much person can do, or this is old age or young age or something like that?
Yeah, they have, there's the age groups, like the first things I told you, the swing bell, like take a karlakate and swing it. It doesn't, you can do in any age groups. Lifting above your head, you have to be above 20. 18 until 20.
No.
Because when you're lifting, when early ages, when you're lifting a karlakata, it stop your growth.
Oh.
So okay. You control your growth. So we can't give a karlakata to lifting up on above the head level.
Okay.
So below your body level, you can do anything, the karlakata.
Okay.
That's why I also always teaching this first couple of rounds, like Ottakai Chuttu, Kaal Chuttu, Ulkaal Chuttu, Kandakaal Chuttu, any inside legs and outside legs. And so this kind of exercise is more fitness for young people. When you get above 20, you can do anything. So you can prepare your body, basically.
Slowly.
Okay.
Yeah, so thank
the
you.
The age groups is started from 6.
Okay. So I understand that to become excellent in this, we must practice about 12 years.
Yeah.
So, okay. So, will that enhance the sports-specific activities? As you said, for dancers, will it be enhanced to sports-specific?
Yeah, it has a lot of movements, to hip movements,
all
the joints, you can mobility in your joints, all the joints you can work it out, all the muscles you work it out. So, it helps for your flow.
Okay.
So, it helps for movements as well as use as a dancing or using as a wrestling. Using like a jujitsu, like a techniques, like a grappling techniques, throwing techniques. It's called the pudivarisai in Tamil. So there's a lot of techniques. Also using any dance movements, hips movements, pelvic movements, knee and stretching your legs. All the movements inside that.
Okay.
As it like people do like yoga asanas. This is not the asanas. It's all about your nilay. They call it stance. So the stands are 64 stands in there. You go and rest on the stands and then continue the movements.
You were referring about Anga Lakshanam, about this practices. How this shapes up our Anga or the body parts into the right shape?
In our traditions, they called Anga Sastram is one of the lessons called Anga Sastram. Your height is 5.6 or 5.7. Your chest level must be this. Your head level must be this. What your wrist level this. Your arm level. Your finger strength. Your finger length. So they all everything have their written our culture. So if you is on the right proportions of your body, then you become the spiritual energy. Automatically you got the energy. That's called Anga Lakshanas.
Oh.
That means you are like a god.
Okay.
Your body look like a god.
Okay.
So that's called Anga Lakshanas. You become look like a god.
Mm-hmm.
So even all the statues in ancient culture, the people who was making a statues, when they studied Anga Lakshanas, and then only they use the sculptures, they make statues through the Anga Lakshanas. The proportion of the eyes and nose and lips, chin bones and face rounds and ears round, ear shape and everything.
Okay. Only by practicing this 64 kind of different type of practices, can we get that whatever saying that
Anga? It possibility. It's possible. That means your body become Anga. Your body is under the mathematics of Anga Lakshanas. You become the body. What is our science says? The physical, the fitness science says you become immortal.
Oh, okay.
So your mortal body will finish, you become a kaya kalpam, you become a immortal. That's why people say that. You call it Buddha body. So you can be a rainbow body. So you automatically you transform your body into a different forms.
Oh, very awesome. So thank you. And while you were referring this Anga Lakshana, you were also mentioning some special kind of diet and other thing, and we have seen here that you are eating once in a day, that's all. Once in a day. So how the diet is important while you're practicing this? Should we maintain a certain specific diet like this or based upon the hungry feeling?
The diet is the more important for practicing Karlakattai.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't need to be eat 3 times a day. Mm-hmm. In our culture, we're not eating 3 times a day. Because we are practically, we are using as a modern culture, changing our culture. Because in our ancient tribes, eating 1 meal a day. That's it, what we are following up. After we have become many food because we culturally we follow up too much food, then we changed our diet and morning diet and lunch diet and dinner diet. We don't need that things. One diet, healthy diet, like a lunch, then your body absorbed completely from the food.
Okay.
So the absorption is 100%.
Mm-hmm.
So is 100% you need absorption, or you are to 30 or 40% absorption.
Mm-hmm.
So if your body, you give the food against in 3 hours, 4 hours, you give food again against the body.
Mm-hmm.
Only 30 to 40% absorptions your body works. So what we need 100% we take absorption from the food. So that's why we eat 1 meal a day and then completely body absorbed everything and then send the waste.
Okay.
That's why culturally we do. And when you do that, you have more strength than 3 meal a day.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
3 meal a day. Because like one time your absorptions, breakfast you eat, they start with 3 hours after the absorption start. Lunch you start after, and then straight away you put lunch on. Within 1 hour you put lunch on.
Okay.
Lunch will take, and then dinner time is absorption start, and then put a dinner again.
So there is no absorption at all?
Absorption at all. Absorption is a slowdown. This absorption is slow
least
down.
Amount.
Yeah, least amount. It's a 20 to 30% absorption you have the food.
Okay.
So that's why we have to eat 1 meal a day.
Okay.
And not a full tummy.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a 40 to 50% of your tummy. And then to 30% of water, 80% only. 20% your prana.
Okay.
So that's 100%.
Okay.
That's the way our culturally we follow.
Okay. So in spite of eating only once, we can able to do complete with the strength we can able to gain.
Yes, we can.
So initially we may face problem. Over the period of time we can gain, I think. Is it right, Master?
It's if over the time your body will understood money.
Okay.
The body will understand. Because once you give the food, the body will starving for food. When you get starved, the body gets starved, straight away start absorption.
Okay.
So the body absorbed every nutrition from the food.
Okay.
So it stored everything.
Okay, thank you.
Mm.
So I have another one question. So for example, a person goes to gym, if he leave his practice after 6 months or something, and he is collapsing his body within 1 or 2 months. So if you do Karlakattai practices for next 3-4 months, and if I leave for 15-20 days, will my body collapse or can I maintain that?
See, when the one of the traditional fitness, it's not in a modern gyms, you can learn for proportion of the body.
Yes.
Body look fit, yes. But it's not a fit. It's external fit.
Yeah.
But in terms of Karlakattai you do, you're not looking for your body. You look the endurance fit.
Mm-hmm.
You're strengthened fit.
Mm-hmm.
The energy level is fit.
Mm-hmm.
So your body, even it's look like improper look, but you don't know how strength you are.
Oh, so strength will be remain.
Strength will always remain you.
Mm.
But you have to follow up your continue.
Mm.
It is like it is very necessary of practicing every day food.
Okay.
As the same thing as a more necessary also practicing every day. Okay. The fitness is more necessary than food. Our culture. When you want to follow the healthy life, you have to be fitness. You have to fitness training. You have to traditional fitness or modern fitness. Modern fitness is only for look. Traditional fitness, how you feel it,
okay.
How strong you are.
Okay.
That only comes from your traditional fitness.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Another question, which I don't know. I also saw that your Selambam videos and other things. We got so impressive about that. So to do the Selambam, you said that we must do the Karlakattai first. So, should we do all 64 and become expertise and then start Selambam, or simultaneously you can start the practice?
Yeah, you can start with a 2 month or 3 month, you can start Karlakattai and then you can start it. Karlakattai is basically for Selambam, boost the Selambam techniques through your grip, hand grips and wrist and mobility and strengthening your arms.
Mm.
So that's why you use Karlakattai. So when you start Karlakattai, you become a stronger.
Simultaneously, you can start after 2 months or something.
Yes, you can start.
Okay.
Master, nice explanation actually. So